1963. Disneyland had now been open for almost 8 years, and Walt Disney and his team of Imagineers were now shifting their efforts over to the 1964 World's Fair. At the time, Disney already had 4 attractions in development for the fair, as a way to fund, sponsor, and test new attraction concepts that would later be moved to Disneyland after the fair's closing. Those 4 attractions were the Magic Skyway, sponsored by Ford, Great Moments with Mr. Lincoln, sponsored by the state of Illinois, Circle Vision 360, sponsored by Kodak, and the Carousel of Progress, sponsored by General Electric. All of these attractions would later be moved to Disneyland, most of them under the same name, with the exception of the Magic Skyway, which would more or less become the People Mover. Children of the World was the working title of the 5th attraction planned by Disney. Fabricated at the Walt Disney Studios in Burbank, California, Children of the World was a water-based boat ride that would take guests through multiple rooms featuring over 300 audio animatronic dolls dressed in the traditional apparel of multiple countries in an effort to represent global peace and unity. Many notable Disney Imagineers known for their work on many other Disneyland attractions and Disney movies helped create the ride. Mary Blair was responsible for creating the attraction's bold, primary color-filled, and whimsical art style. You may know Blair as the art director for multiple Disney animated features like Cinderella, Alice in Wonderland, and Peter Pan, as well as the art designer for a lot of the murals in Tomorrowland at the time. Note that distinctive art style. Similarly to many of the other Disney attractions at the time, Mark Davis designed the scenes and characters, while his wife, Alice Davis, dressed the characters. Raleigh Crump designed the toys, props, and other items seen on the attraction, besides the characters themselves. Like a lot of the other animatronics at Disneyland, as well as the Walt Disney and Mickey Mouse statue that you see today, the ride's characters were sculpted by Blaine Gibson. By the way, all the ride's characters share the same face to represent unity. The ride's boats and propulsion system were designed by Aero Development. Among other things, you may know them for making 6 of Disneyland's opening day attractions, being of course the Mad Tea Party, the King Arthur Carousel, Dumbo the Flying Elephant, Snow White's Scary Adventures, and the Casey Jr. Circus Train. The original plan for the ride's onboard soundtrack was to have each doll sing the national anthem of the country they were representing, depending on the room that the guests were in. While this may have sounded good on paper, it yielded some not-so-promising results when put to the test. Basically, the audio was never in sync, and was just a crappy, disharmonic, discordant amalgamation of random music. So, Disney turned to the Sherman Brothers. You may know them as the writers of pretty much every other Disney soundtrack. Walt Disney famously said to them, "I need one song that can be easily translated into many languages and be played as a round." The result was It's a Small World After All. When the Sherman Brothers first presented the song to Walt, it had a much slower tempo. Walt thought that the slow pace of the song wasn't cheerful enough, so the tempo was raised. Walt was so pleased with the resulting song that he actually renamed the attraction after it. And with that, It's a Small World got its name. The ride was aptly shipped over and added to the 1964 World's Fair's UNICEF Pavilion, sponsored by Pepsi. At the attraction's entrance was a 120-foot tall spinning kinetic sculpture called the Tower of the Four Winds, designed by Raleigh Crump. The tower was actually added to represent the boundless energy of youth. The attraction was unbelievably successful, selling over 10 million 65 to 95 cent tickets over the course of 2 half-year seasons, with the proceeds being donated to UNICEF. A big innovation of the ride was the loading system, being able to serve many more guests per hour than the other attractions as a result of multiple boats being on the flume at a time. This new water ride system was so successful that it would be incorporated into many other Disney attractions, most notably being the Pirates of the Caribbean ride, which was originally planned to be a walkthrough attraction. A little over a year later, the entire attraction was permanently shipped over to Disneyland following the closing of the 1964 World's Fair. The attraction was added to an area that had previously featured a stop for the Disneyland Railroad, which is why the Disneyland Railroad runs through the ride's facade today. Though the ride was mostly the same, the Tower of the Four Winds sculpture was sadly not included. However, the ride did get a new facade, also designed by Raleigh Crump, in the art style of Mary Blair. On its opening day at Disneyland, Walt Disney invited several children from around the world to pour water from their native countries into the ride's water flume. Following the loading process, the ride's boats take guests through multiple rooms, each representing a different country, with dolls in each room dressed in the native apparel of that country, singing the It's a Small World song in that country's native language. The nations that are represented in each of the rooms are the United States, England, Switzerland, Italy, France, India, Canada, Scandinavia, Thailand, Japan, China, Korea, Brazil, Mexico, Africa, and the South Seas. Originally, there was a New Guinea room, which was later replaced by the United States room in the 2008 refurbishment. Over the years, It's a Small World has undergone multiple refurbishments and sponsorship changes, making minor changes to the overall ride. When the attraction was first shipped to Disneyland, it was sponsored by Bank of America until 1990, then Mattel from 1992 to 1999.
You can tell it's Mattel. It's swell.
This doll was added during one of the remodels as a tribute to Mary Blair. Perhaps the largest changes to the ride took place during the 2008 refurbishment. The loading system was changed to have guests enter on the left and right and exit down the middle, as opposed to the previous system of having guests enter down the middle and exit to the left and right. In addition to this, the flume and boats were replaced, and multiple permanent fixtures were added to the facade for the ride's holiday overlay. The most controversial change was the addition of 37 Disney character animatronics, including Woody, Jessie, Aladdin, Mulan, Ariel, Flounder, Nemo, Cinderella, and many others. Of course, each of the Disney characters were more or less added to the countries they're from. This refurbishment also reintroduced the Farewell Sun and Tapestry at the end of the ride, the likes of which hadn't been seen since the 1964 World's Fair. Over the years, various changes have been made to the exterior facade. In 1977, shades of blue were added to the white, gold, and silver paint scheme, then pink, white, and pastel accents in 1992. In 1991, portions of the facade were removed to make space for the entrance of Mickey's Toontown. Other than that, very few other changes have been made to the ride. In fact, a lot of the props featured during the ride still have shipping stickers from 1966 on the back of them, according to FreshBaked. The It's a Small World ride has also been added to many of the other Disney parks around the world, including Walt Disney World, Disneyland Paris, Hong Kong Disneyland, and Tokyo Disneyland. And that completes a brief history of the It's a Small World ride at Disneyland. If you guys enjoyed this video, it would be absolutely amazing if you guys could like this video and subscribe to the channel. With that being said, I am the Space Mountaineer, and hopefully, I will see you in the next video.